Good evening, everyone. So let's take a controversial topic. So before going to topic, if we ask that on which grounds it can be supported, or against, what will tell? I think you have read already, no? It is old topic. Or by the time we take, you may have already studied. So, on which grounds we can support? Not more, tell 5 points. Read. Equality. Read. Rights. Equality, freedom, liberty. Then right to worship. Right. Included. Said, whatever you will tell, it will go in that. Said, good point. Public place. Any other? Read. Legality. Reasons. Rationality. Gender, although it may come here, but we can write it, but let me add it. Dignity. Now, tell against point. Core. Core and non-core. Core and non-core. Yes. Said. Tradition. Custom. Identity. Diversity. Religious freedom. A board of? Take care of freedom of religion. Freedom of religion, law should not. State should not intervene. Yes.
Considering deity's nature.
Deity's nature. Take That is also one point, right? Deity fundamental rights. No. When he is subject to petition, he has also fundamental right. Right. Any other? Good. Social harmony. Any other point do we have? They will all come under. Social morality. Basically, it is nothing but if question does not ask any views, so this is answer to that question. But we have to take a choice. No. So how many of you prefer social morality over constitutional morality? Anyone who supports judgment of Supreme Court? Sorry, anyone who is against judgment of Supreme Court? No. So rational people. Yes, anyone who is against, suppose, Supreme Court judgment. There is no point. Yes. Diversity. Right. So, is there any problem in Supreme Court judgment? No problem. So, what happens in LGBT case? Was it legality or social morality? Society, no doubt, it is a point. Change should come from society, not from judiciary. Dead. But should we wait for that change? Right. Now these things should be seen, let's say that, should be seen in the light of many other developments. Any means other developments, you can say that okay, we have been talking on uniform civil code. We have been talking triple talaq. Right. So, and demanding equal right. Or let's say that okay, we have been talking of gender equality. Right. The party which is resisting Supreme Court judgment is vocal supporter of uniform civil code. Right. So we have, let's say, many other gender equality. Then you have to take also this rationality into criteria. Right. At the same time, one thing will come, that key, diversity. Diversity plus change. If you don't write all details. Right. When judgment has been given, so some issues have been raised. One, whether we are moving towards constitutional theocracy. So whether it is a constitutional theocracy, one article was written on that. Right. Second is whether judiciary is a right institution to decide about core and non-core aspect of religion. Right. So what constitute core and non-core of the religion? Whether judiciary is the right institution to define it, segregate it. And third is that how the change should come in society. Whether change should come by judiciary, or already we have one such topic in first class itself. Judiciary alone will not be adequate enough to bring changes in society. It should be backed by other institutions. So that can be another one. Then, let's say that the other side is that who should decide, means this temple, etc., purity, impurity, other such aspects. Right. So another dimension is called equality when we talk, rationality when we talk. But on the other side, let's say religious belief, tradition, custom, etc., that we have. So there can be those substantial aspects, but there are also some legality, let's say legal technicality. There are some legal technicality in that. What does it mean when we say those legal technicality? And legal technicality cannot become the basis, a locus standi, let's say that. When the legal technicality change, judgment change. That may can also happen. So, but that's a different thing. Before that, some facts you should know, which you may have studied, you know that. About that Sabarimala temple, so you should know some basics of Sabarimala temple. That some basics are given, you can read it. How it was, it has its root in ancient time. Then after that, anything which is historically available is called 12th century. So from 12th century, this is how some facts we have. And it is according to some information 1910. So Lord Ayyappa temple was installed. And it was innovated also in 1950. And this is how, let's say that, since this temple during British time was managed by the British rule, means the British state, and therefore when India got independence, so they transferred the management right from their, let's say, institution to state, Indian state. And that is how you should know that there is Article 290A. According to Article 290A, state is responsible for management of the temple. And therefore, since British state also used to pay for the management, similarly, let's say that the Kerala state also pay as per state consolidated fund of India, 46 lakh. So 46 lakh is paid from state consolidated fund of India, right, for the management of the temple, which may be, let's say, more nowadays 50, 56, whatever. But state pays through state consolidated fund of India as per the past history. And this is one such fact. Another fact is that when this came into question, so certainly let's say that when we got independence, we did not have any entry, no entry issue. And also let's say that this came when Kerala state passed one such law, right? Hindu places of worship, right? Authorization, rule and law, 1965. According to that, let's say that for the first time it was invoked in 1991 by Kerala High Court. It means that before 1991, there was no issue of entry, no entry. In past, women used to go to that temple. Right. if you see the past practices. It was the Kerala High Court let's say that if he's issued a ban on that of women aged 10 to 50. Right. So if you take the legality, legality means it will be Kerala that Hindu right, places of worship authorization rules and law. That is one, Article 298 second. They are the legal aspect. And if you take on that basis, plus temple is not a private property of anyone. This. So they constitute it a public place. So because of those two laws, plus any temple or any mosque, any such religious place is not a private property basically. It is considered as a public place, and when it is considered as a public place, so any public place people enjoy equal, let's say that key access, if you take Article 15. So according to Article 15, it is declared as this is how this public place. And when it is a public place, so every citizen has equal right to visit that public place. So this you can see from legality perspective. We'll come to your point. Let me finish. Now, second thing is that rationality perspective. Right. The rationality perspective is called concept of purity and impurity and gender discrimination, which is most important point. Forget about fundamental rights, forget about anything else. The most important point is rationality. Rationality is this: can we treat men and women body biologically different? Yes. Now, can we consider if biologically they are different, the one is of, let's say that key lesser good and other is of higher good, then the right equality concept should not be there. So, even if they have biological difference, but you cannot treat one as lesser good and other as higher good. Otherwise, we will not have right to equality. Second, third point. Who has given the concept of purity and impurity? And will women subscribe to that? Will women accept it? Right. So who has given the concept of purity and impurity? Will women accept it? Here I will tell one point. Every religion has concept of purity and impurity. Sacredness. Every religion has this. Right. Basically, when you worship, so when you feel that you are neat, clean, safe, right? No. That's why people go and let's say that take a bath and then they go for worship. Any religion. Right. Any religion has one aspect that there should be purity, let's say that. Purity of not mind, also body. And then it is considered as appropriate for worship. Now, so, but no any religion has this discrimination. Right. If purity is the concept of in any religion, so no any other religion says no, women should not go. There can be some, let's say, very specific cultural religious practice, this we are not talking. Right. So no any religion talks that. Even if they have the concept of sacredness, purity. Right. Next. How can you bar 10 to 50? What is the logic of this? Right. 10 to 50 in toto, let's say that. Wholesale ke bhav mein, sorry to say that. So in toto, 10 to 50. Right. Kuch exceptional case ho sakta hai after 50 ka bhi. सॉरी टू से दैट, और कुछ एक्सेप्शनल केस होता है बिफोर 10 के भी, राइट? सो इट्स नॉट साइंटिफिक क्राइटेरिया, राइट? दिस नेक्स्ट रेशनलिटी वी आर टॉकिंग, विच इज मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज लॉ रूल्स एटसेट्रा विल कीप चेंजिंग. अगर हिंदू वो पब्लिक ऑथराइजेशन प्लेस का रूल नहीं होता, राइट? सो सुप्रीम कोर्ट इज स्ट्रक इट, राइट? दे बोलेंगे कि नहीं, वी आर एडिक्वेट एनफ टू फंड, यू डोंट फंड अस. इफ लोकल सिस्टम इज चेंज, बेसिस ऑफ जजमेंट चेंज, राइट? सो लीगैलिटी इज नॉट एज इम्पॉर्टेंट, बिकॉज दे कैन बी क्वाइट एडिक्वेट एनफ टू फंड देमसेल्फ. दे विल से कि स्टेट्स शुड डिसोसिएट, राइट? दिस इज हाउ केरला गवर्नमेंट कैन ब्रिंग चेंज इन द लॉ. Right, so that's different thing. Rationality we are talking, which is most important. Then we are talking goddesses, Hindu god, goddesses, not gods, goddesses. Whether Hindu goddesses are embodiment of men body or women body? Certainly women body. So whether they were not 10 to 50 years, when they are women embodiment, so why we consider them only pure? That's why you worship, right? So women goddesses are worshipped, and there is no concept of purity, impurity, right? This, and they are embodiment of women body, not men. This next purity impurity is individual dispensation. When you are generally not in a proper state of mind, not pure, etc., you have not taken bath, etc., you do not want to go to temple, you do not want to go to religious place. Aisa hota hoga? Right? Aisa nahi hota hai. So what is a guarantee that the men are always in a pure state? Right. And what, why you say that women is always in an impure state between 10 to 50? Right. I will tell, many men will not be, as per the criteria of sacredness, in a pure state. Right. But purity and impurity they have defined. And that is how, let's say, so since you define concept of purity impurity, so men, I will guarantee it, there is a concept of sacredness in every religion, right? Even when we go to our mass, so we have to be, let's say, paak saaf, jisko bola jata hai, right? Means you should be, let's say, neat, clean. This is how it is. At least you should take bath, etc., right? Sorry to say all these things. Even in Hindu religion, those priests are there. And priests also take water after urination. Right. They use also after urination water to keep themselves, right, shuddh. Isn't it? So, can we say ki all men, if a priest is doing it, to all men are also doing it? No. Right. So from that perspective, let's say that men are also impure and they should not also be entitled. But that is left to that person. It is his self-control. It is his inner self to decide whether he wants to go in that state, in temple, in mosque or not. Right. Rather than imposition. Right. So this is how, let's say, another point we are talking from rationality, concept of pure and impure. Next, if women are really impure in that age bracket, and he is celibate with due respect, let's say, to Lord Ayyappa and that people having belonging to that religion or worshipping, with due respect, let me tell all these things. So he is not only a celibate deity. We have also many other celibate deities. I think Hanuman was also, if we consider him, human or what? Right. Whether he is human or not, but he is a deity, can we consider, worshipped. If Hanuman is also celibate, and I think women have not touched him. Right. So, yahi pe hai, ye bagal mein aapka, right, bahut bada, sabse bada Hanuman mandir. I think ki Hanuman will not be only celibate, many other people will be celibate. Right. We don't have a list of that. So, can we say that ki when they go and touch, they become? If one deity become impure by touch of a woman or the presence of a woman, then other deity will also become. Right. Isn't it? The same logic applied? But it is not. Next, last. When you remember God, in problem. That time, do you think whether you are, your body is in a pure state of? No. You do not remember. What is ultimate aspect of religion? Spiritual attainment. Isn't it? According to Supreme Court. According to you, it can be achieving, getting success in UPSC. But what is main aim of religion? All religion teach one thing, enlightenment, I guess. No. Enlightenment. This is how it is. So if you bring rationality as a concept, let's say that. Rationality, thinking those things. So this concept of purity, impurity, if you are bringing. Right. Abhi to ho sakta hai, aap support karoge. Basically, ki many men will not know it. Right, the actual aspect, as to women, right, and we know that in Hindu religion it is quite practice, and even women are not allowed to go in kitchen in morning without taking bath, right. This is practice in our society, it is a social morality you can say. Or religious practice, you can say, belief, you can say, with due respect, it is practiced. Right. But will this practice be accepted by women, right, of today's generation? Right. Will they accept this practice? Right. Certainly, let's say that when you talk about equality, so you will not support this idea. When you believe in rationality, you will not support this idea. Right. Purity, impurity is a concept of state of mind, which have been brought on the basis of rituals, traditions and custom. Right. So those rituals, traditions and customs have resulted into creating a particular state of mind, and that's why let's say that when these things are breached, so you get upset, you get tension, you are not able to tolerate it. For you, it does not matter. Why it does not matter? Because you don't believe in that. But the people, those who believe in that, if let's say that Bahu goes early morning in the kitchen, then you know Sasuma what she will do. Right. So there should be sudhikaran of kitchen. Havan hoga, achha hai, khane hone ko milega. Right, sorry to say that. So that is how it is practiced in our religion, and it is, let's say that, part and parcel. But let's analyze the concept of menstruation, right, and concept of, let's say, purity, impurity. Will you check this menstruation, etc., when women is playing any such important role? Because any important role, let's say that, so if one deity feels that polluted, impure, the other place should also get polluted, impure. Right. Other place will also get. How will take it? So, it is, let's say if you talk from a rationality perspective, It is also dehumanization of women. Right. It is no way bringing concept of this let's say menstruation, purity, impurity. It is no way humanization if you talk from a rational perspective. Right. And if you talk from their belief, tradition and custom practice, no doubt, it is also defilement of that deity. This is how they conceive it. They may be right on their point because they have the traditional belief. But what we will do of our rationality? What we will do of many other things of society today when we have all that, let's say, liberty, equality, freedom, rights, right, that we are trying to guarantee, and let's say one after another we are trying to dismantle the discrimination and give them equal right. So, from this rationality perspective, let's say that it should be considered that this is a discriminatory practice done by them. Because purity, impurity will be considered again a state of mind. Right. It is not based on rational thinking. Right. It is not discussed in our class, life, society, etc. But recently one thing I think articles have been written, you may have read it. Right. This society has not still accepted the biological difference of women. Right. And it is highly, let's say, masculine society. And we, mother is also given a very different space in society, place in society. But mother biological difference is not recognized. You do not want to recognize it because mother is also a woman. So she is also a woman, let's say that, but you do not want to recognize her biological difference. Right. And your daughter or your wife, because women will be, let's say that, certainly, so you will have your wife, you will have your daughter, you have your mother, but you do not want to recognize their biological difference. On that criteria, you are deciding that whether they are pure or impure. And who is saying that pure, impure? So men are saying pure and impure. Why your celibacy should be affected by others' impurity? Right. If you are celibate, so you are celibate. Right. Why your celibacy should be affected by others' impurity? So, if you take on these points, plus if you talk all constitutional, let's say that, liberty, equality, freedom that you have, Article 14, Article 15 we are talking, then Article 21 if you talk, this way you can take it, public place already explained it, region rationality we are talking, gender equality, then next is called core and non-core. But before that I want to tell again that rationality aspect, right, people may have a negative view. People may have a negative view, right? But let me share that since I am married, so I have also certain understanding of that period. Let me speak a bit frankly. And women that time want support, right? And that time women is not given support, right? This you should know that. So she is kept in family something, distance. But that time she wants support. In fact, they face at times so much problem that they think that why women has been subject to every month this kind of, let's say that, cycle and not men. Right. So many a time they feel and if we are not, let's say, taking into consideration, that somehow we are not trying to recognize again the same thing, the biological differences and the problems. Right. And then you keep talking about human dignity, respect, equality, many things we keep talking. So for what? इसलिए आई ऑलवेज से दैट राइट व्हिच काइंड ऑफ पर्सन यू आर द सर्टिफिकेट इज गिवन बाय योर वाइफ सॉरी टू से दैट राइट हाउ लिबरल यू आर तो सर्टिफिकेट वहां से मिल जाएगा राइट सो दिस इज हाउ आई विल टेक योर क्वेश्चन लेट मी एक्सप्लेन मीन्स फिनिश इट then core and non-core aspect of religion basically which is becoming basis you should know that ke polygamy was rejected by supreme court beard has been rejected by supreme court skull cap has been rejected by supreme court in case of muslims that ke they are not core part of the religion in recent times similarly let's say that ke in other religions the shani temple and Haji Ali Darga so there also they have brought core and non-core concept and they say it is not core part of that right similarly let's say that in this case also they say that concept of this purity impurity sanctum sanctorum etc which we are talking about right and let's say not allowing women it is not core part of your religion right core part of the religion non-core part comes in 1954 in one such Supreme Court judgment and since then they have gone on building it up again and again again in 1984 they reiterated about core and non-core and then let's say that thereafter it has become now part and parcel but it was for the first time in 1954 it is given in your notes you can see that there they define ki what is core part of the religion and they say that the core part of the religion is the religious methods which take human or a person to spiritual achievement spiritual attainment although it is not properly defined it is vague but this is how core and non core part another technicality they have brought and then let's say 4-1 judgment in that 4-1 judgment four judges overwhelmingly support it one Indu Malhotra so she does not support it she says that rationality should not be brought in religion and this is how social changes should not be brought by court and therefore she has given a dissenting view right that is how you can say on the part of this supreme court view etc which in 1991 they say then a pil is filed in 2006 2008 in kerala and that is how it moves to the supreme court and those chronology you can see finally in let's say 2018 they pass a judgment let's say on this side what they are saying basically the dissenting judge view ki religion should not be second is already let's say that ki since they say that ki they have been practicing it and it was his wish it was the lord ayappa as a deity he wished that ki women should not touch him this is how so he wished that ki women should not touch him this is how people they are arguing and see since he wished it and therefore let's say that ki women should not be allowed right this is one there are some other some examples they are giving let's say that right even let's say ki our one what we say generally Smriti Irani let's say that she has also given one such a statement and she is let's say Hindu and her husband is Zoroastrian and let's say that she is not allowed to enter in the Zoroastrian that religious place right because non Zoroastrians are not allowed this is what she has also given a logic right so there can be some such religious places where you can find only women going or only men going right or there are some let's say that places they also argue that ki religious place is not a what we can say tourist place religious place is based on certain belief, tradition, custom. It follows certain rules, procedures within religion. It has certain rituals and they have their religious sanctity. Therefore, it should not be treated as a general place like a public place or let's say that a tourist place. Then they argue religious freedom, let's say that religious freedom means the constitution gives the religious freedom, especially again 25, freedom of religion, 26, freedom to manage religious affairs. So that they also argue that under freedom, right to freedom of religion, so court should not intervene in this matter. Our court does not have the jurisdiction on this matter, and court should not define what is core of religion and what is non-core of religion. That is how their arguments. But if we see, let's say that, taking all these things into consideration, if I again take one thing which today's society, if you take scientific temper, if you take rationality, if you take the basis of all those things which teach equality. So, there can be regulation in some other fashion, but a total ban of 10 to 50 years of age cannot be justified. So, it cannot be justified. Because again the same thing, then you discriminate women. It is not just discrimination, it is dehumanization. Other things can be taken, otherwise we cannot talk of equality, dignity. It is basically, let's say that equality, dignity, rights versus identity. So, those who are, let's say, worshipper of Lord Ayyappa as deity, they have certain identity, let's say that they want to protect their identity or protect their culture, But then there is a conflict with the rights and also dignity, dignity of women. So, this is how the conflict, etc. And, depending on your, let's say that, but the judgment of the court should be supported. Although always Supreme Court judgment, so yes, the court should not impose theocracy, that is constitutional theocracy. Court should not, let's say that the court has brought the concept of core and non-core, which is arbitrary. The court needs to be more clear, means more consistency in its concept. More sound in its concept, what is core of religion, what is non-core of religion, and certainly let's say that change should come through society. Harmony is also one such important aspect. Society may not be ready always to follow constitutional morality. Society may be more, let's say that acceptable to social morality. So constitutional morality should not also be imposed. Rather, we should try to have a gradual change in society. And constitutional morality is not always superior to social morality. This you should also know. Social morality is in some situation also superior to constitutional morality, or we need to have. But that point I will, let's say, deal later on, means just after a while, what the relationships. But this is how, let's say that we can say that we do not have a choice not to support Supreme Court judgment, otherwise we will not support the rationality in the society. But certainly the judgment results into triggering lots of conflict, tension in our society. And that is how, let's say that we have to ensure also that social harmony is also maintained. And it is the duty of the state. Now, it is duty of the state to ensure that the court judgment is implemented. This is how. It is duty of the state to ensure the court judgment is implemented. State should not show a weak sign of non-implementation. Otherwise, faith in constitution will also be affected. They take oath for having faith in constitution. No, oath of faith in constitution. Constitution is the fundamental law of the land. And they take oath of this. Right. In fact, in one such speech, Prime Minister has spoken, the only holy book for me is constitution. Right. This you can say that. So he has spoken in one such speech, only holy book for me is constitution. Right. Constitution is also based on faith of people. Right. And people have also faith in religion. How can we differentiate it? The social contract is based on faith, trust. Right. And religion is also based on faith. But religion has lots of differences, diversity. But social contract is one. So this is how that constitutional morality is also a matter of faith. Social morality is also a matter of faith. The only thing is that one is more liberal, advanced and rational, and other is more social. Right. This basis we can take it. And that is how we should support. Yes, now you can ask your question. Right.
For example, on the last day of Navratras, people invite little girls to their home and they worship them. But then, if men went to go to the ladko ko bulana chahiye, then the purpose of that tradition will defeat. Like in this case, Lord Ayyappa, he wanted to he don't want to be in contact with women. But if we start allowing women to enter the temple, then the purpose, very purpose of that belief, that story behind that belief, that will defeat.
Yes.
So don't you think that
yes, good question. That is how the point. If you start questioning, because the basis for religion is belief. Right. This is how. Yes.
So can we seek or meet God only by visiting a temple? We can seek God from our mind.
Yes, means. I thought similar question, but your question is different. Any similar question? Let's take it. Belief. And you told some practices. Yes, still in our society, there are many cultures. There are many cultures, cultural practices, where it is well understood ki male, female, etc. There are. For instance, after death in family, a man takes, I guess in Hindu, some rituals. Right. It is done by a male member in the family. Right. So it is done by a male member in the family. Now it is accepted. Right. It is acceptable as long as, suppose, ki a death has happened in a family. And there is no any male member. And suppose a female wants to do the role of male. And suppose society does not allow. Then state will enter. Right. So as long as the beliefs are there in our society, they remain in the confine of our social life, which are not causing, let's say, trouble, problem. The state does not have a business to look into. Right. But the day you take away right of another individual, right, then state has the role to come into that. Right. So now the question will be, why not female should be allowed to play that role? This has been a tradition only male should play, since male members were there always found. So it was not a problem, it was not questioned. But suppose a female comes. Right. Similarly, let's say after death in Hindu, so let's say you have funeral. In funeral, let's say that ki fire, etc., and only male members do that. But at times females have also done. Right. So first time when a female did it, there could have been lots of trouble. Right. So many religious practices we have, it is well accepted that ki male, female and separation happens. Right. And it is acceptable practice in our society. But let's say that ki when a situation come where female also want to play the role like a man and then she is not allowed, then state enters. It is like this. We have a class here, and as long as our class does not create any problem for society, right, the state has no business. But suppose in the class I start teaching you something objectionable, right, the state has a role, right. So this is how the freedom we have, right. So the belief should also be in the same way. In our family, whom you marry, how you marry, what you do, which religion you follow, what you eat, what you do not eat, when you eat, which you invite, which religious priest you invite. Largely religious priests are male, let's say that, and there used to be also only Brahmin, let's say that, but gradually society has gone. You have also female priest, but generally it is that you have a male priest. Right. So already society has learned it and segregated it. Society has segregated, classified certain socio-cultural practices associated to gender differences. Right. But their gender differences, when they become discrimination, then the role of state comes. And that's why, let's say, this is a belief where now it is a temple. Right. Suppose hypothetically, as long as the deity was, say, alive, right, he does not want to meet a woman. So yes, it is his right. He does not want to meet, so nobody will meet. Right. Once you have a worshipping place, right. See, place of worship is a public place now. Right. Because it is in under state. Right. And that's why, let's say, state will have some role in it. So we cannot completely separate it. But the issue will be that which belief state should question and which belief state should not question, there we may have disagreements. Right. Because of our differences in view, values, preferences and thinking. That is what we'll answer. Yes.
Sir, Transport was acquired to merge to India. Then the properties, movable and immovable properties of Lord are also taken by government. Then there is agreement between the temple and the government that rent will be paid, not as a fund. Then how can we consider like 290A's, like it has to be rent, right?
It is a rent. So state is paying a rent. Means there is a state involved. Basically this. Forget about how much they pay. I told that they have enough property, etc., that they can run themselves. But there is a role of a state involved. This we should tell that. That is how the legality. Yes.
Sir, there are few temples in India that have this type of restriction. But there are temples which don't have that open for. Then why states will interfere in particular? Because these are exceptions. And there are many temples where men are not allowed.
Yes. Maybe next time. Right. Again, देखो prima facie अगर आप लेके आओगे तो वो change हो जाएगा, तब का logic change हो जाएगा. आप कोई भी local standardi आप अगर लेके आते हो, उसके basis पे logic देना. So the prima facie, the basis, the thing you are bringing for logic ना. If I change it, then your logic changes. These things should not be strong reasons for. If some temples they are not allowed, then why should not be? Right. This is not a strong logic. It is one such a counterpoint, but it should not be strong logic. Right. Because what if tomorrow a petition is filed, then what court will do? Right. Gradually society will move towards more universal practice. Gradually. So maybe tomorrow the petition can be filed also. Right. So it is not a, let's say that again, right way to say or argue that it should not be. But again I will go with one thing, that is called rationality. Right. Is it rational to have the concept of purity and impurity in the religious belief? Right. And deny discrimination if some women want to go. Right. This is how. And it is not rational. As far as Indu Malhotra's statement is concerned, there should not be religion, rationality in religion, so then forget about Vivekananda, forget about Raja Ram Mohan Rai, forget about post-Protestant, and forget about religious reforms, forget about uniform civil code, you forget anything then. Right. So, Protestant religion comes because of reforms. Vivekananda is a rationalist and Raja Ram Mohan Rai is also a rationalist. Right. And then let's say that other religious reforms that we are talking, it is on the basis of rationality. Right. So you cannot say that there should not be rationality in religious belief. This will not have, let's say, wide acceptance. Yes. That will deal it.
Can we seek God only by to that
temple? No, that is a different question. Not substance question does not have a substance. Because if some people want to reach to God by that way, so there should not be a problem.
In that case, the main question here is that you cannot stop me reaching Lord Ayappa in my mind, and God is accessible everywhere.
Yes. Yes, yes, accepted, yes. That second point is good. Right. Yes, people may reach to God by different means. This we are not questioning. But certainly they should not stop other people to reach to God the way they want to reach. Right. Yes, this is how it is. That is how the conflict. Yes. Accepted. Accepted. A woman does not know. If you give, again her logic I don't find substantial. A woman does not know that there is a concept of PIL also, hence she is discriminated. Then, many a time you have to play on behalf of people. Right. This. Then past history, if you see that. Why women were allowed in past? Right. There is a rice eating ceremony for the children and women used to go there. No? So why they were allowed that time? If it had happened in past, let's say that, so then how can you bring now it? This is how it is. Right. Right. Basically, let's say that, let me tell now, positive aspect of social morality. These are all social morality. Social morality is also good for society. Right. Why? Because society, they cannot live with legal morality in day-to-day life. Every time, this is your right, this is my right. No. If you put it in family, what will happen in every family? Right. So, number of divorce rates have increased because of legal morality. Sorry to say that. No. Ek cup tum chai banao, ek cup main. Ya tum apna chai banao, main apna. Theek hai, sorry to say that. Right. Suppose women says, right. It has happened in some cases, that's why I am saying, right. So, suppose you take entire legal aspect, right? If your wife is tense by law, right? She will cause lots of trouble to that person, right? So, you cannot take it. It is more of we are human and social relations, etc. We take. So, social morality still play much more wider role in human life. Even if we are quite aware about rationality, legality, highly educated, but still on human ground it happens. Right. So we should not, let's say that, consider social morality something demeaning. Right. You cannot have in society empathy, harmony, right, social, let's say that, feeling of togetherness, etc., unless you have certain level of social morality. Right. The social morality is also very essential for our society. This you should know that. Second aspect is that social morality in many cases is better than constitutional morality. Means legal rights as per law. We should not act always rights as per law. Social morality is also important. Why? Because how human will unfold, law cannot think of. Some of the human behavior, human action, human relations will be not in, let's say, thinkable as per law. Right. And that's why, let's say that, constitutional morality, which is called legal morality, morality by law, right, should not always overwhelm social morality. Now let's take an example. Right. Recently we have asked one essay, in that we have given that, right, legal contract. Right. So in one such surrogacy incident, there was a legal contract for one child. Right. And twin child born. Right. He has a contract for one child. So he can fight for his right. My contract is for one child, not for two child. Right. And yes, he is right. Right. So, how you will decide this case? Either you go against law, or you enforce law. Enforcing law, you know it is not right. Right. If child is born abnormal, I have a contract with that child should be healthy. Right. So you have entered into contract, the child should be healthy. And child is abnormal. Then what you should do? Right. So this is a similarly in my divorce cases, generally it happened. Who should take the child? Who should upbring the child? Who should have custody of child? It is not decided by law. Right. It is more decided by the social condition. No doubt economic condition as well. Right. So, you should know the positive aspect of also social morality. We cannot make society a legal society. Right. Society will always remain as society, and social morality will be always, right, wider part of human life. Right. So that is how, let's say, we have to balance it. You were asking about conclusion. The towards end, this is how you have to refer the positive aspect of social morality. Right. Constitutional morality seems to be superior here, seems to be cosmopolitan type, better. But social morality has also relevance in our society, because major part of human life is guided by social morality. Right. And social morality bring, let's say, since it is close to feelings and emotions of human, right. Therefore, let's say that social morality brings a sense of satisfaction. Right. This is how. So, it should be also accepted in our society. It should not be considered something negative or denigrated or derided. But at the same time, when there is a conflict between social and constitutional morality, seeing the broad connotation of constitutional morality, in general, it should get preference over social morality. Because constitutional morality is a kind of ethics, and social morality is a kind of morality. Right. That is how you can write it.